they're kicking in, you know, in relationship to that aspect. You know, it's general education dollars, of course, that is supporting the vast majority of it. We provide custodians or helping facilities out here. So, yeah, it's just a partnership across. But you know, it hasn't been a drain also. You know, once we got the initial investment to build the facilities, because you saw the rooms we started with, yep. It was like a one-room schoolhouse up here for a while, even out to the barn, I think, for a while. But then once we got the facilities, not a lot of additional cost to the public because of the partnership that we have with providing the electric transportation.
And so the city owns the building. Everything, the bonds are, I don't know if you said it was a wait, but then after the bonds, we're still paying the bonds.
No, we actually paid them, we paid the bonds off.
Okay.
So just read.
Okay.
But I'm just, as an example, we just did an improvement to the roof within the last couple months, right?
Mm-hmm.
And run through the city. So, I mean, it's just a pass-through for the city for the most part. I actually learned the complexity of the partnership when we were looking at doing a solar project. I thought, well, if there's a building in town that should have solar on the roof, it's the Prairie Wetland Learning Center. And so, looking at the complexity of all that, and it's something that, you know, with government, you know, it's not always easy. It's
yeah.
Remarkable. Trust me, it's remarkable the partnerships that we're able to create to let this place function. And it also includes Lakes Country Service Cooperative, who's also a nonprofit. Name excited for our
I appreciate that you said it was complicated. That's why I'm trying to like step it through.
Yeah.
So I know, and then you guys cover the teacher, I'm assuming, in supplies.
Right.
And then everything else.
Right. So through our congressional appropriation, those professional money service, the funds that are allocated to the first falls around the district plan, supports our staff. They interface with the Fergus Falls School District teachers. So we have two staff members that work very closely with Fergus Falls as well as other communities. We're responsible for the day-to-day function and maintenance of the facility. The city insures the facility, so like we have wind damage or things of that nature, so we work with the city that way. So you're right, it was, I got a heavy dose of it when I first started here in 2018 because all of our agreements were expired. I don't know if that was planning or what that was, but good for me to be able to dig into those. And they are so unique. We are, it's creatively, just very, very impressive that we were able to do this. It's almost like we were ahead of our time in a lot of ways. And to sustain it with folks that are ensuring that we're following all the regulations and the policy, they're just scratching their heads. And they just kind of say, yeah, it sounds good. It really does take, I think, at that foundational basis, trust and communication. And our staff works very closely with Fergus Falls School District in terms of the teachers. We work very closely with Ben and his staff and with Lake Country Cooperative for just having this constant open dialogue and making sure that we're all on the same page all the time. So.
And because of this partnership, it just doesn't exist in fourth and fifth grade. You know, because we have such a close connection here, we're bringing everything from kindergarten to high school students out here, you know, on a sporadic basis. They may come out for double periods in seventh and eighth grade. We're getting all students exposed to this both early and late, you know, in their environmental education.
So how many fourth and fifth grade classes do you have?
So we have about 200 students per grade level. So we've got about 8 different sections of 25 then. And we've kind of maintained right at about that 50%. Like half the students have been involved. And you can be involved in fourth grade, or fifth grade, or both.
Yeah, there was a couple of kids I talked to.
Yep, I've been there for two years.
Okay.
And we've really found over the years that by choice, it's about half. And probably in fourth grade, you can't quite get them all in, but they're guaranteed a placement in fifth grade. Because we kind of have to keep a little bit of class size balance in our other sections as well. So we're probably limiting them to about 100 students. But over the course of those 2 years, everybody who wants to get in, at least gets their full year.
100 students for both fifth and fourth and fifth, or just 100 students per grade?
So then 100 fourth and 100 fifth would be involved each year.
Just to quantify that, think about the footprint of this program within all of the other communities. I mentioned Morgan comes out. We have about 57,000 student contacts per year. So, you know, that's pretty astronomical number coming through the front door. So we're basically booked, with the exception of around some of the holidays and teacher workshops and those kinds of things. Our staff is booked pretty much every day of the week for 9 months out of the year.
And you have a dormitory.
We do have a dormitory, yes. It's an opportunity to provide, it's one of those opportunities that's never fully fledged itself, at least not yet, right? but we're looking for opportunities to think more broadly, more farther away, other opportunities that maybe there are kids in Metro Minneapolis and St. Paul that we might be able to make contacts with or have that opportunity to showcase this place to them as well. So
each year we usually have to turn away student teachers because we get so many requests to come and experience this type of an educational setting as a student teacher. But our staff are very willing to accept those. And then they can take the program off to somewhere else. And, you know, maybe they can't be full fledged like this, but you know, if you've got a problem in the back of your school, go for it. It's an opportunity. So, and just to mention that Minnesota's got some interesting weather. And one thing that we're teaching the students is to be a little tough and hardy, because when they come out here, they're expected to go outside every day. Every single day. I mean, if we're 31 below, we might be thinking about it. But if it's 10 below, they're dressed for the weather and they're going out. So they're going to use that outside classroom.
I've been out here to share my experience. I've been out here where it's been that close to zero. And the kids tuck in around the cattails out on the marshes. And they just take their gloves off and they're out there journaling about things that they see. But they're out of the wind and so it's not nearly as cold, but they're out every day.
And those type of classrooms get an opportunity to be exposed to a trained naturalist, you know, U.S. Fish and Wildlife, or the interns that they've provided for us, at least every week, if not more than that. It's amazing. I mean, you couldn't recruit that in your school on a regular basis any other way.
And how long?
You've
been doing it since
So the first science class, last week is today, we've been going since 2008. So we're in 2009, somewhere around here. The day use program, where kids are coming from Morehead, or third graders are coming out for a day from Purpose Falls, or whatever the case might be, that's been going on since 94. Yeah, because we started in the barn next door here.
They're consistently adding property in the surrounding area. So we continue to explore ideas in relationship to expansion of even our program. You know, we do some different things if we're able to bring, because we don't want to put too much pressure on this site as well. You know, we're going to be out there every day. So we're looking at all kinds of possibilities about the expanding the program by way of using some additional resources that they've acquired over the last few.
Do you attract open enrollment because of the program?
I know for sure that we attract open enrollment based upon the kids we get in the Purpose Falls area. Because we may get this, you know, let's say that we've got a Catholic school here in town. Well, those students might make the decision to come to the public school in fourth grade or fifth grade rather than seventh grade as a traditional style. Just so, oh, I'd like to